was Krishna a king or a president? Were Yadavas a republic? What is a Ganasangha? Let's find out. Hello, this is Pranav and you're watching Pravyavnav, a channel where I talk about history, mythology, fiction, film, series, and occasionally food and travel. Subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon. You must have heard about the ancient Athenian democracy of the Greece or the Roman Republic, but did you know about ancient Indian republics that existed? That is today's topic. In my last video, I talked about how Yadu was cursed that he and his successor would never become kings, which is an allegory probably to say that they were republican states. We'll get back to that, but let us just understand the beginning and the origin of states in ancient India. All these kingdoms, they emerged, but when they emerged through election. Several family heads or kulapatis elected among themselves a Vishayapati, a head of a canton or a settlement. These Vishayapatis, many Vishayapatis, elected among themselves a Janapati or a Rajana, the head of the whole tribe. But actually, the word Rajana literally means ruler and not a king. A Raja can be elected or a Raja can be a monarch. It can be anyone. So that is why many times when we read ancient literature, many democratically elected leaders were also termed as Rajan or Raja. And this is where it gets confusing. Now from the Mahabharata, we get an idea of how the Yadavas at Dwarka function. They were not a kingdom like the Kurus and the Pandavas. They were more like a republic, and not just any republic, a federal republic. In the Mahabharata, there is a conversation between Narada and Krishna where Narada calls Krishna his Sangamukhya, a title which can be translated as a federal president. But from the functions that they discuss, it feels like he was also like a speaker of an assembly. The Yadavas had an assembly called Dasarhi, while their hall was probably named Sudharma. Yadava assemblies had four main political fractions or parties. They were the Vrishnivarga, the Bhojavarga, the Andhakavarga, and the Kukuravarga. These vargas were presided by a federal president who was kind of a speaker but probably also the president. So their tribe were their party and their party was also their tribe. Not much different from what we have today, isn't it? In their conversation, Narada advises Krishna to use his soft language to keep the federation from falling apart, because there were two political parties headed by Ahuka and Akrura who were fighting among themselves. They respected Krishna, but they were still fighting among themselves like anything. Now we don't know much about how they function, but we know something about the later republics that existed at the time of Buddha. There was this Vrajji Confederacy or the Vrajji Sangha, which was kind of a federation just like the Yadavas of Dwarka. So from the Vrajji Sangha, we know that this republic had an assembly and they elected an executive from among themselves. These executives were the president or Raja, the vice president or Uparaja, the treasurer or Bhandardarika, and the Senapati or the head of defense or a commander-in-chief. They had a political whip so that a party votes the way they do, just like what we have today. Votings were done through secret ballot, through whispers, and also in open. The secret voting was done using a piece of wood of sala plant. From Kautilya, we know there were two different kinds of republics. He bifurcated them as Shastropajivin Sangha and Rajashabdojivin Sangha. Now, if you notice, Rajashabdojivin Sangha was probably a republic through words, probably a democratic republic, and Shastropajivin sounds like a republic through weapons, which could mean it was a military junta probably. Critics of this Gana Sangha call them an oligarchy and not a republic, because the society was divided into two classes, the Kshatriya Rajkula and the Dasakarmakara. The Kshatriya Rajkula owned land and had right to vote, while the Dasakarmakaras were landless laborers. But it could also mean that the Kshatriya Rajkula were the local citizens, while the Dasakarmakaras were foreign migrant laborers. But if you compare it with the Athenian democracy, their class society was also divided between patricians and plebeians. And patricians owned land and had right to vote, while the plebeians didn't have owned land and they couldn't vote. But still we call them a republic. But as hung assembly obstructed the workings of a republic and nepotism gave rise to dynasties, slowly these republics faded and were conquered by larger empires. And this is how ancient republics were destroyed. This is Pranav signing off. Ta-da.